I was saying, y'all, your boy Rico coming with a Burgundy and Gold report. Just want to talk about the injuries that both the Burgundy and Gold Washington football team are facing and the Cleveland Browns. Now, overall, they have more players mentioned in their injury reports, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they will have more players not playing come Sunday. But starting with us, you have defensive end Ryan Anderson. He didn't participate in practice Wednesday, but he was a full participant in Thursday's practice. Expect him to play. You have tackle Sadiq Charles, rookie. They said he had a setback, so don't expect him to play at all, maybe even not for the next couple of weeks. Linebacker Thomas Davis was a full participant today. Defensive back Kendall Fuller was a full participant, and we're finally expecting him to make his again debut, I guess? His 2020 debut, at least, for the Burgundy and Gold this Sunday against the Browns. Then you also have linebacker Cole Holcomb, who has not participated in practice so far this week. Do not expect him to play. Then you have defensive end Ryan Kerrigan, full participant today, as in Thursday. Expect him to play. Wide receiver Steven Sims was limited in today's practice Thursday, but it's quite likely that he will play. And then tackle Morgan Moses was limited Wednesday and didn't practice at all Thursday. And that's like a big alert right there, because without Morgan Moses, this offensive line is already struggling without Brandon Sheriff. I mean, Brandon Sheriff was getting beat, granted, but Wes Schweitzer came in and was technically even worse as far as one-on-one goes. Now, our offensive line looked better overall, but that's more so because of Scott Turner calling for quicker throws and shotgun and more of a hurry-up, up-tempo offense. That wasn't necessarily the offensive line was better after Brandon Sheriff left. Wes Schweitzer came in and performed even less impressive than Brandon Sheriff previously was before he got hurt. And then Morgan Moses, honestly, has probably been our best offensive lineman, at least the most consistent. I mean, that one block where he ended up pushing the defensive lineman into Brandon Sheriff's leg, which is why Brandon Sheriff got hurt. That wasn't a good block, but overall, these past 2 weeks, Morgan Moses has been doing a good job, honestly. So us not having him is going to be really bad against the Browns, especially dealing with Myles Garrett. Now, Jerron Christian has been way better than what a lot of people have been giving him credit for, especially against the Cardinals. He was actually pretty good. I mean, he had a couple of plays that was a little but as far as pass protection goes, he did a way better job than I expected him to do against Chandler Jones walking into that game. So at least we have him. Wes Martin still needs to get better. Chase Relia has been holding it down, being slightly above average like we expected it. But Morgan Moses has actually been our best, at least most consistent offensive lineman. So for him to possibly not play against the Browns is going to be very challenging for us. It could be a dark day. I'm not playing. And then for the Browns, you have defensive end Adrian Claiborne with a hip injury. He has not participated in practice all week. You have linebacker Jacob Phillips with a knee injury. Hasn't participated in practice all week. You have Olivier Vernon, ex-Giant, defensive end. Hasn't participated in practice all week. You have tackle Jack Conklin with an ankle and finger injury. He was limited Wednesday and was a full participant in today's practice, so expect him to play. And that's great news for the Browns, because they definitely need him against our defensive line, which is the best in the NFL already. According to DVOA, Advanced Analytics, according to Pro Football Focus's grading systems, we have the best defensive line in football. I believe we also technically have the best defense overall. But I know for a fact they said our defensive line is the best in the NFL. And the Browns having somebody like Jack Conklin is huge. They're also going to need a great game from Jedrick Wills, because so far he's only allowed 3 pressures this season. Between both games, he's only allowed 3 total pressures, while Chase Young on the other side has gotten at least 4 pressures a game. And I feel like Jedrick Wills is definitely going to lose this matchup, but Jedrick Wills is a nice young talent and may be able to hold up Chase Young better than what people think. But I'm definitely expecting Chase Young to have a big day against him and Jack Conklin. Chase Young is just that great. Our defensive line is just that great. We have the best defensive line in football. The Browns don't have the best offensive line in football. I'm expecting us to win that matchup all year, really. But back to the injuries. You have cornerback Kevin Johnson with a liver injury, full participant in Thursday's practice. You have J.C. Treader, the center, with a knee injury, limited in Thursday's practice. You have cornerback Greedy Williams, shoulder injury, limited in Thursday's practice. You have linebacker Mack Wilson with a knee injury, limited in Thursday's practice. And cornerback Denzel Ward doesn't have a status for Wednesday's practice, but he was limited in Thursday's practice. And Dwayne Haskins already said in a press conference that he's used to going against Denzel Ward back when he was the quarterback for Ohio State. So he's ready for him, even if he does play. And then tight end Stephen Carlson, wide receiver Jarvis Landry, and linebacker Sione Takitaki were all full participants all week. So expect all three of those guys to play. And going into this game, I definitely feel like we have a good chance to win. I definitely feel like the Eagles overall are a better team than the Browns. And I feel like the Cardinals are one of the best teams in the NFL. And we didn't get just completely obliterated by them. And we beat ourselves a lot of the time with fumbles and missed blocking assignments and just little things. It's like, if we were just more prepared, if we had a preseason, we could have had a way closer game, possibly could have even won it, because it was a lot of momentum changing small things that made big differences in that game. And so with how we played against the Cardinals, who I believe is one of the best teams in the league and will definitely make the playoffs, I definitely feel like we have a good chance against the Browns, who is probably the least difficult opponent we've faced so far this season. I definitely feel like the Eagles are better than the Browns. Now, the Ravens the week after this is another story, but the Browns will definitely have been our, which you can kind of say, easiest opponent so far on our schedule. And I definitely feel like we can go in here and win this game and control it early, especially with starting fast on the offensive end like Ron Rivera has been preaching. And it seems like Scott Turner may actually try to get some short game, quick throws, giving Dwayne Haskins dump off options and running back screens to get him started early and fast so that we don't have to come back the second half like we've done these previous 2 weeks and try to play from behind to win games. And then our defense is just, I feel like it's too dominant. Baker Mayfield is not who we thought he was after that first year. And interesting note, that one great year we've seen from Baker Mayfield was the year that Ken Zampese was his QB's coach, who is now our current QB's coach. But Nick Chubb, a Georgia Bulldog at that, is a different type of guy. Kareem Hunt is right there with him. According to Pro Football Focus elusive rating, through the first 2 weeks, with a minimum of 20 carries, Kareem Hunt is the most elusive running back in the NFL, according to Pro Football Focus, and Nick Chubb is number 4. But we have a demon on our side too. Antonio Gibson, they have him rated as the second most elusive running back in the NFL so far these first 2 weeks. But it's just the fact that they have two of the top four. So that's going to be a problem. My main concern is stopping the run. But if there's a defense that can do it, it's this one, because John Bostic and Kevin Pierre-Lewis have been balling out there. I mean, Pro Football Focus has given Kevin Pierre-Lewis a grade of 91.3 overall. And the only defenders with higher grades than him are TJ Watt and Shelby Harris. That's literally it out of the entire league. Any defensive player in the NFL, according to Pro Football Focus's grading system, Kevin Pierre-Lewis has the third highest grade, which is a huge pickup for us in the offseason. And from what I saw from him when he played for the Bears, I knew he had a lot of potential. It was just whether or not we could tap into that potential. And it seems like Jack Del Rio and Ron Rivera found it. And he was a great open field tackler. I mean, the complete opposite of Trey Apke. He was making a lot of great solo tackles out in space against a lot of shifty guys. Between Kyler Murray and Kenyon Drake, Chase Edmonds, Kevin Pierre-Lewis looks like that guy, and he's pretty good in coverage. And John Bostic has also stepped up pretty big. So our front seven is loaded. It's just whether or not our defensive backs are going to be ready. But this is going to be the first week we get Kendall Fuller back, so I'm expecting our DBs group to definitely hold it down better than they have been. And it's like for Troy Apke, honestly, with just the law of physics and just pure logic, he can only go up from here. He can't get worse than what he was last week. Baker Mayfield is nowhere near as mobile as Kyler Murray, and our defense still played pretty well overall until they were gassed last week against Kyler Murray. So now dealing with a far less mobile quarterback. I mean, Kyler Murray's easily top three most mobile quarterbacks in this league. So going against Baker Mayfield, I'm expecting this defense to shut it down pretty much like how they did the Eagles in the second half in the first week of the season. The defense still had a pretty good game, almost great, against the Cardinals, honestly. It was just a lot of bad field position moments because of the lack of offense and then the bad plays on special teams. But overall, the defense played pretty well against the Cardinals. But technically, they still took a step back from their performance against the Eagles. I'm expecting them to bounce back and be that top three, arguably best defense in the NFL against the Browns again. And I'm expecting us to win this game. I think this will be a fairly defensive game. And I'm thinking we'll win 24-14, honestly. I'm just feeling it. I really do feel like we'll win this game. And that's me kind of banking on Dwayne Haskins and this offense getting going early. But I think it's very possible. And now that Antonio Gibson has shown more and more each week what he can do, and he still needs to work on his vision a little bit and become a little bit more patient. But you saw throughout that game that he started to develop those traits better, and then he just started being even more deadly. And I'm expecting him to just keep taking more and more steps forward as we go through this season. I'm expecting him to have probably his breakout game against the Browns this week coming up, especially if Morgan Moses is healthy. Now, Odell Beckham Jr. and Jarvis Landry are a problem, but with this front seven constantly getting pressure on Baker Mayfield, and he won't be able to run around like how Kyler Murray did, I'm expecting us to bottle him up, get probably five or more sacks this game, and then Odell Beckham and Jarvis Landry won't even matter how open they are, which I doubt they'll be just because I'm expecting Kendall Fuller to come back and play strong. I'm expecting Fabian Moreau and Jimmy Moreland to have bounce back games. But even if Odell and Jarvis are open, this front seven won't allow Baker Mayfield to get them the ball or even see them. And he's just going to be rushed constantly. He's going to be on his back a lot of QB hits, a lot of pressures, a lot of sacks. I'm expecting big things out of this defense this week and for them to have probably their best performance of the season so far. The only person we're missing on defense right now is literally Cole Holcomb, but even if fully healthy, he wouldn't be starting right now over Sean Dion Hamilton, Kevin Pierre-Lewis, and John Bostic. So I feel like our defense is going to win us this game, but I definitely feel like the offense will look better than it has these previous 2 weeks, especially now that Scott Turner is starting to learn what Haskins is good at, how to make this offensive line look less bad. With that up-tempo offense and everything, I'm expecting us to come out early and get it going. But yeah, man, that's the end of this video, man. I really appreciate the view. Please like the video if you liked it. If you learned anything, please subscribe if you haven't. Please hit the bell next to the subscription button so you get a notification every time I release a video like this one, or I schedule a live stream, or I start up a live stream. Y'all already know, I live stream during every game. Then after the game, we take like an hour break, and then we come back for the post-game live stream where y'all can call in and voice y'all opinions and everything, and I give my post-game analysis, and we just go back and forth and all of that. Also, big shouts out to all of my supporters. Thank you to everybody that donates. Thank you to all of my sponsors, especially the Pro Bowl sponsors whose names you see scrolling on the screen right now, and I'm gonna catch y'all later. Probably trying to get a film session out to y'all tomorrow, Friday. Probably will be Antonio Gibson. I'm really intrigued about his game so far these past 2 weeks and how much he's already progressed just within two games. So the film session may be Antonio Gibson. May get that out to y'all Friday. Definitely want to try to get it done by Friday because I have my Georgia Bulldogs to watch Saturday. And make sure y'all talk trash in the comments. Burgundy and gold, Cleveland Browns, teams of other NFC East teams, whatever. Get in the comments and talk y'all stuff, man. But all right, y'all, man. I'll catch y'all later. I'm out.